Hello all, today we will be discussing about the design of taxiway. In the previous video, we had already gone through the theory of taxiway. Just to revise, taxiway is used by aircraft to facilitate their movements between runway and hangar, apron or terminal building. So they act as connecting pathways. Here we will be discussing about how to calculate the turning radius of the simple taxiway. Now first of all, what is turning radius? The change in the aircraft path is done by providing smooth horizontal curve. The design should be such that the aircraft can negotiate the curve without significantly reducing the speed. Now, taxiway radius is decided on the basis of following three criteria. The first is type of aircraft. If the aircraft is of larger size, say Boeing or Airbus, you will require greater radius. And for smaller aircrafts, you will require less radius. Now next criteria is the speed of aircraft. If the speed of aircraft is more, so to negotiate that speed, you will require greater radius. And if the speed of the aircraft is less, to negotiate that speed, you will require less radius. And the next is the Horngeff's equation. Now you will have to follow all these criteria, and whichever will give you the maximum turning radius will be considered as a final turning radius. Okay, so we'll start with the first criteria, which is nothing but type of aircraft. Now, as given by International Civil Aviation Organization, the recommended radius corresponding to the taxiing speed of large jet airplanes are as follows. For subsonic aircraft, it is 120 meters, and for supersonic aircraft, it is 180 meters. Now, what is subsonic aircraft? The speed of aircraft when it is less than the speed of sound, like it is for most of the commercial aircrafts, those are the subsonic aircraft. And when the speed of the aircraft is more than the speed of sound, those are nothing but the supersonic aircraft. So, this criteria is supposed to be remembered. Your next criteria is the speed of aircraft. The relationship between the exit speed and the radius of the curve is given as R is equal to V square upon 125F, where V is nothing but speed of aircraft in kilometer per hour. Capital R is the radius of curve in meter that we are going to calculate, and F is coefficient of friction, which is usually taken as 0.13. The next is the Horngeff's equation, the third criteria, where an equation is given, which is nothing but R is equal to 0.388 capital W square divided by 0.5 capital T minus capital S. Now what are these terms? Capital V is nothing but the wheelbase of aircraft, T is the width of taxiway, S is distance between point midway of main gears and the edge of taxiway pavement. To make this understand easily, we'll go through this diagram where this black strip indicates the taxiway. So you can see width of taxiway T, this is the width given. Then the front gear, which is called the nose gear, the back gears, which are called the landing gear or the main gear. Now what is wheelbase capital W? The center distance, the center of the main gear to the center of the nose gear, that distance is called the wheelbase. Okay, then next is what is wheel tread? The center of the main gears, center to center of the main gears, is that distance is given as wheel, known as wheel tread, which is denoted by small t. Okay, then next is your S, like given here. What is S? S is the distance between point midway of main gears and edge of taxiway pavement. So you can see S here, midway of the main gears to the edge of the taxiway, and that is thus indicates capital S. So this is how the terms are represented. I hope you have got this. Now using this criteria, you will calculate the turning radius. Take the maximum value of the turning radius for the taxiway calculated by these three methods. Now just to revise the terms, I'll show you one figure, which is this figure, where the airplane is shown here and the taxiway is shown here. Okay, then these blue lines are nothing but the edge of the taxiway. So the taxiway width is given by capital T. Wheel tread, that is the distance between the center point of the extreme main gears, that is the wheel tread. The center, that is the front gear, which is called the nose gear. And wingspan, the distance between the edge of the wings, is nothing but the extreme edge of the wings, is nothing but the wingspan. This is the nose gear and others are the main gear. Okay, now you could see here S. As I have shown you in the last figure also, your S is nothing but the midpoint of the main gears to the edge of the taxiway. Okay, so how you will calculate this S? Half of the wheel tread plus 6 meter. Now, what is this 6 meter? This 6 meter is a value to be maintained while taking a turn on the taxiway. This 6 meter is the distance between the extreme end of the main gear, center point of the main gear of the extreme main gear to the edge of the taxiway. So this 6 meter distance has to be maintained while taking a turn. So how you calculate S is half of the wheel tread plus 6 meter. So I hope you have understood this figure. Now we'll go through the numerical related to design of the taxiway in terms like designing of its turning radius. Okay. Now, to start with the numerical, first of all, you are supposed to know what is the type of aircraft, what is the wheel configuration of the aircraft, and what is the speed of the aircraft. Now, we'll go to the first numerical. What does it say? A taxiway is to be designed for a type A airport operating Boeing 707, which have the following characteristics. Length of the wheelbase is W, capital W, given as 18 meter. Turning speed V, that is given as 45 km per hour. Tread of the main gear is 6.5 meter and lateral friction given as 0.13 meter. So this I have first of all started with all the given data: turning speed, length of the wheelbase, lateral friction F, 0.13. So as discussed prior, S can be calculated as wheel tread divided by 2 plus 6 meter, which is the distance to be maintained. So wheel tread is given as 6.5 meter. You can see here, tread of the main gear. So 6.5 meter divided by 2 plus 6 is nothing but 9.25 meter. So this is how you calculate capital S. Now, depending upon the three criteria as discussed prior, you will have to calculate the turning radius. First criteria is type of aircraft. We know that for supersonic aircraft, turning radius is taken as 180 meters. For subsonic aircraft, it is taken as 120 meters. Since in the question it is given, the aircraft is Boeing 707, which is a subsonic type of aircraft. Hence, R is directly taken as 120 meters. The next criteria is the speed of the aircraft. This for calculating the radius from speed of the aircraft, this is the formula which is used. R is equal to V square upon 125F. We already know which is 45, 125 into 0.13 which is given. So R what we get here is 124.61. Okay. Then the third criteria, which is nothing but the Horenjev's equation. Now what is Horenjev's equation? 0.388 capital W square divided by 0.5T minus S. So capital W that we already have, which is given as 18 meter length of the wheelbase. Okay. And 0.5 into, now this 22.5, we know that for different types of airport, that airports are classified into different types. And in the question, it is given, it is a type A airport. So for type A airport, wheel tread is a standard value, which is nothing but 22.5 meter. This you can find in books also. Minus S, which is already calculated, which is 9.25. So hence we get R is equal to 62.86 meter. Now we have got the turning radius from the three criteria. First is 120, third is 124.61, and third is 62.86. So maximum of the three is 124.61, which we have got from speed of aircraft. So this we will be taking as the final turning radius. So this was one type of numerical. The other type of numerical is this type. Determine the radius of a taxiway for a supersonic aircraft to negotiate the curve at a turning speed of 55 km per hour. The wheelbase is 28 meter and the gear tread is 7.1 meter. The airport is of type B as per ICAO. So the given data I have written: turning speed capital V, that is 55 km per hour, length of wheelbase W 28 meter, lateral friction F 0.13, that we have assumed since it is not given in the question. Okay, so first of all we will calculate capital S, which is nothing but wheel tread by 2 plus 6, that is equal to 7.1 divided by 2 plus 6 is nothing but 9.55 meter. Okay, now for type B airport, width of the taxiway. Okay, as I have previously discussed in the previous question also, this capital T is nothing but width of the taxiway, and this width of the taxiway is a standard value given in all the books for type A. In the previous question, it was type A airport. For that also, it is 22.5 meter. In this numerical, the width of the taxiway is also 22.5 meter, which is the standard value for type B airport. Okay, Now, from the first criteria, then we will discuss. Since it is given that it is a supersonic aircraft, it is given in the question. So R could be directly taken as 180 meter. Then speed of the aircraft R is equal to V square upon 125F. Okay, from the speed of the aircraft, you will calculate R as 186.15 meter. Then third is from the Horenjev's equation. So from the Horenjev's equation W, we know it is 28, which is already given. Then 0.5, capital T is width of the taxiway for type B airport, it is 22.5, minus 9.55, which we have already calculated S value. So R is 178.94 meter. So maximum of these three values is nothing but this, 186.15 meter. So maximum of the above three is considered as the final turning radius. So the turning radius become 186.15 meter. I hope you have understood this numerical. Thank you so much.